Hi friends, welcome to Tech and Travel Bug. Today I'm going to make a video on Tally. Those who didn't watch my previous session of Tally, they can watch that video. I will provide that link in my description. You can go through that and watch my videos and continue to watch my current session which I'm doing today. Today I'm teaching you one feature in Tally, which is Billwise Detailing Tally ERP 9. Billwise Detail is one feature which is useful to get outstanding report of suppliers or customers. So how it will work, how we should work under this feature, we will learn in this session of Tally. So let's start. Open the Tally. Work in educational mode. I will give Alt W here, S for select company and press enter. So our company is open, list of selected companies, test company. Date of last entry 2nd April 2019. We are working in educational mode of Tally software. So in our previous session we learned how to create masters and how to pass entries. Basic vouchers we have passed, and then shortcut keys also we have learned how we can use shortcut keys in Tally. So basic thing we have covered. So today in this class I will tell you how to use this small feature of Billwise. While working in Tally, while passing entry, we can use this feature, and by using this feature we will come to know how we can get the outstanding statement of our suppliers or customers. Outstanding means if we have to pay some amount to supplier, means outstanding to supplier, then by using this feature we will come to know how much amount we have to pay to our supplier, how much amount is pending to pay. That outstanding we will come to know, and same way customer side also, if customer has to pay some amount to us, then outstanding receipt, how much amount we have to receive from customer, that also we will come to know by using this Billwise feature in Tally ERP 9. This feature we are using to give the outstanding report. Outstanding report we require to know how much we have to pay suppliers and how much we should get from our customer. For both these things we need outstanding report. By using this Billwise feature we will come to know outstanding report of our company. So how we can enable this feature in Tally ERP 9, what and all we have to configure in Tally, how we can make entry by using this Billwise details, everything we will learn one by one slowly. So first we have to enable this feature in Tally software. That is the first step. We have to enable this Billwise details in Tally. There are so many features in Tally software like this Billwise. For any new feature we have to enable that feature in Tally software first. So first step, we have to enable Billwise. Where we will get that Billwise option to get enabled? That option is under F11 features here. You can click on this F11 features, or else you can press a F11 function key. So in F11 features we will get accounting features, inventory features, statutory and taxation. Like this we will get in company features. In my previous session I told you What is this company feature, accounting features, inventory features, and statutory and taxation is for. We are using today bill-wise feature. This is purely accounting related. So if any feature which is related to accounts, then we should go accounting features. If it is related to inventory, then we should go for inventory feature. And if it is related to tax, then we should go for statutory and taxation. I will go to accounting feature. See here, accounting features thing you are getting. Here, we have to enable this feature. Under outstanding management, we have to enable maintain bill-wise detail as yes, it is already enabled in my company. If it is not enabled, you have to enable here. If it is no, then make it as yes. Enter. Same way, under that bill-wise details, you have one more line for non-trading account also. If you want to maintain this bill-wise details for non-trading account also, you can make this option as yes if it is required. Otherwise, you can keep this as no itself. No need to make it as yes. If it is required, then you can make use of that. For non-trading account also, you can use this bill-wise details. So after that, just accept the screen. Don't give escape directly. You have to save the screen by accept yes. Otherwise, it won't get saved. So, our bill-wise feature, we have enabled this bill-wise data. This is the first step we should do in Tally. After enabling this bill-wise feature, we will get bill-wise options in Tally. What is this bill-wise option? How it will work in our voucher entry? Voucher entry, I will go to accounting vouchers V. So, here, I have already explained you about all these vouchers, how it will work, what type of transaction we should make entry in, which voucher we should pass that entries, all that I have explained you. So I will directly go to voucher entry. Under bill wise feature, you will get few options. First, I will take purchase voucher. We have passed 3 vouchers under purchase. This is the purchase number 4 vouchers. While making entry, you will come to know. I will explain you in that time. Just pass one purchase entry. I will select here supplier A. Here I will use shortcut key Ctrl A. Purchase account, enter. I will give space bar. List will come. Select request stock item, enter quantity, enter rate, amount will come, enter, enter, enter. Right now you are not getting that feature. One more configuration we have to do to get the bill-wise details. That configuration I will tell you. First step we have done, that is enabling bill-wise details in Tally. Then two configuration we have to do before passing voucher to get that bill-wise option in voucher. What is that configuration? One thing, that is under that ledger, any ledger, it may be supplier or customer. Under supplier and customer, we need this bill-wise details because outstanding report is for supplier and also customers. So in that ledger, we have to enable one option. I will give Ctrl Enter shortcut key for alteration. Ctrl Enter. After enabling bill-wise details, we will get one new option, maintain balance bill by bill. This option is no. In my first class, I told you there is one small feature, this bill by bill, that I will explain you later. So today I am explaining you about this bill by bill option. So how it will work, we can see now. Maintain balance bill by bill, I will make it as yes. Just give Y and enter. See here, maintain balance bill by bill, yes. For the supplier A, we have to maintain balance bill by bill. And also here when you give yes, it will show two more lines, default credit period and also check for credit days during voucher entry. Default credit period means, see, when we are purchasing some item, supplier will give 15 days credit period or 7 days credit period. Like that, supplier will give credit period to us. Means, in that period, we have to make payment. Otherwise, some interest rate will be applicable for that outstanding amount. See, for example, we are purchasing some product from our supplier for 1 lakh worth of product, and for 1 lakh worth of product, the supplier will give 7 days working period. After the 7 days, there will be interest rate 3%, 4% depend upon the company. So that percentage will be applicable on that 1 lakh rupees. After that specified credit period, we have to pay interest for that. Means 1 lakh plus that interest rate we have to pay to our supplier. Same it will work under our customer also. How we will pay our supplier, same way we will charge to our customer also. That same scenario will be applicable to our customer. So if you are giving any credit period, then you can use your credit period. Or else if any interest rate is not there, then keep it blank, press enter. Check for credit days during voucher. And if you want to check that credit days during voucher entry, you can enable this as or else enter. Here I didn't give any credit period, so I'm not going to make this option yes also. So I just accept this screen. Enter, or else control A shortcut key. Always while you working in Tally, make use of this shortcut key. So once it became a habit, it will be very useful to you to work in Tally, and also it will save your time. Enter. Still that feature we are not getting. While I told you one more configuration is that two configuration we have to make. We have done one configuration. Another one is you have to configure under this F12 configure. F12 function key. Here what you have to do is use default for bill allocation. You have to make it as no. If this option is yes, then bill wise details option won't come in a voucher entry. Use default for bill allocation should be no. Means default bill allocation we are making it as no. Just you have to make this as no. Use default for bill allocations. Accept this screen. Now you pass this entry. See here. Now you are getting this bill wise details. So we have enabled bill wise details. After that we are getting bill wise details option in Tally by configuring in Ledger Master and also by using F12 configure in voucher entry. So after that configuration we will get this bill wise details. How it will work, how we can work under this feature, I will tell you one by one. So under this bill wise details you will get four types of adjustment. While making entry, you are getting this four option. Which you want to use, that you can select here. For selecting, there is some rule. Depends upon that, you can select here. What type of method of adjustment you have to select, that I will tell you. See, there are four types of adjustment while making entry. Advance, against reference, new reference and on account. Right now we are making which voucher entry? Purchase voucher. We are purchasing from supplier. That is the scenario here. While making purchase entry, you have to select method of adjustment. The purpose of using this bill wise feature is to get the outstanding report. Outstanding report means how much amount is pending from our customer and also how much amount we should give to our supplier. To know the outstanding report, we are using this feature. So you should know why we are using this feature, what is the use of this feature, you should know first. Then you can learn how to use this feature in Tally. Method of adjustment, we are getting four types: advanced, against reference, new reference and on account. While making purchase entry, we have to select new reference. Always, if it is purchase or if it is sales voucher, we have to select a new reference. Why we have to select new reference? Because we are purchasing stock item from supplier. This is not advance. Advance means, you know, if we received any advance amount, we are taking it as advance. While looking into this name itself, we can understand advance. This is not advance. We are purchasing it from our supplier. Advance, when it will come, if you have taken some amount advance, that time advance adjustment will come. Now we are purchasing it from our supplier. Normal purchase voucher and sales voucher, we have to select the new reference. Advance and on account, I will tell you one by one. Right now you just see how new reference will work. For purchase voucher and sales voucher, we have to select a new reference. That's it. For purchase and sales, you just select new reference here, and here it will ask for billing. The voucher number we are passing is for number 4, so 4 will come automatically. This option is for, right now we are doing purchase voucher, we will save this entry. After saving this entry, while making payment for this purchase, we should make payment, right? So when we are making payment, we have to select this new reference as against reference. While making purchase entry, we have to select new reference and save this voucher. And when we are making payment entry, we have to select this new reference and accept that payment voucher. While making payment, we have to select this new reference, which will come when we select against reference, it will come. So don't get confused here. You just see what is purchase voucher, which one we have to select. Then you will come to know one by one. New reference I will select here. For purchase and sales voucher, you just select new reference. That's it. And here bill name, we have to give what is supplier name. Because there is so many supplier, there will be so many customer. So you can't find out which supplier, which payment. When you selecting this reference in payment voucher or receipt voucher, you're not able to find which voucher, which entry payment you are doing or which receipt you are taking. You can't make out. So for that purpose, we have to give that supplier name, bill number, which you can identify. Like that you can give. Normally I will give here supplier 4, short form I have given here supplier 4. So when the supplier, when we are making payment to the supplier, that time I will select the supplier 4th number voucher we are making payment. Like that I can find out this entry. So because of that, we have to give here under name, we have to enter here. Here due date of credit, we have not given any credit days, so let it be blank. Enter. That's it. Purchase entry, while making purchase entry, we just have to select the new reference and have to give bill name, that ledger name and bill name we have to give. Or if date required, or if anything which you can find out in list, you can give just simple understand, you can give that ledger name and voucher number, it's enough. So purchase entry we have done by selecting new reference. Then I will show you payment voucher, how it will work. From supplier A we have purchased item, so now I will make payment for the supplier 1,49,700. Full payment I will make here. See here, while making payment voucher also we are getting this method of adjustment. Before enabling this feature, this screen we were not getting before this screen. After enabling this bill by details, for every voucher entry we will get here purchases, receipt and payment. Like this voucher entry we will get this option bill by details. So now what we have to select here, against reference. See here what I told you, now you can understand I think which entry I did in new reference, that I will get in against reference here. Supplier 4 I have given here and date is 2nd April, balance 2350. So like this it will show. If you have few more voucher it will show you list. Right now we have only one voucher, so easily we can make out. But if you have so many entries, then you have to select from that list. For identifying that particular voucher, I have given here supplier 4. Supplier is ledger name and 4 is voucher number. If the same supplier have 10 voucher entry, then you can't find out which voucher he is making payment. So for that purpose, I have given supplier 4. Means for 4 voucher we are making payment, like that to find out. So just select that entry, that's it. So purchase voucher you have to select new reference, and while making payment of that purchase you have to select that it as against reference which you have passed in new reference. And a purchase voucher that will come in payment voucher as against reference. So you have to settle that payment. I don't save this voucher because I want to show you how report will affect. So I will just show you report of this outstanding. I won't save this payment voucher. I just saved purchase voucher, and after that I will come once again here and I will show you so that it will clarify clearly. So where we will get this outstanding report? For any feature there will be a report. For getting that result there will be a report. So for that report we have to go to display. Under display we have to go to statement of accounts, and under that outstandings. Oh, under outstanding you have few options: receivables, payables, ledger, group, like that. I will go to ledger option. I can go to payables because purchase I didn't make payment, so it will come under payable. If it is receivable it will come under receivable, like that. So I just select a particular ledger, supplier A. See here, supplier A is pending to pay. Supplier A we have to make payment 1,47,350. We have to make payment. Escape. Directly we will go to payables. So see here, how much is pending? 2,350 is pending. Why 2,350 is pending? Because in ledger supplier A, if you press enter here, 1,45,000 we have purchased and 2,350 we have purchased. This is a previous transaction. Just go through this voucher. Enter, 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 enter. Here 1,40,000 is there. So three vouchers. So totally 1,49,700 we have to pay. Payables is 1,49,700. We were getting only 2,350, which was actually 1,49,700 because one issue was there, because today we have passed one purchase voucher. Before that we have passed a few more purchase voucher. For that, this feature we didn't enable, so that entry was missing from this report. So I just accepted that voucher again, so it got affected. Means in that purchase voucher also I have selected new reference in that two voucher, so it's taking into this bills outstanding report. So if any payment is pending, every voucher it will show here. Which voucher entry you should make, that voucher will display here. So 1,49,700 we have to make payment. If you go to receivable, nil, because we no need to receive any customer payment, means everything is settled. There is no pending payment from customer. So that's why bills receivable is nil. If you go to bills payable, it will show. For this three vouchers, we have to make payment. Same way, if you go to ledger wise also, you can see supplier A 1,49,700 is pending. Opening amount 2,350, pending amount 2,350, due on 2nd April. Like this voucher will show here. Same way group wise also you can see this report. If you select sundry creditors, will come to know 1,49,700 is pending. So this four menu will show group wise, ledger wise and receivable and payable wise also. Which one you want, you can see that report. I will come out from that screen and I will go to payment voucher now. Now we will understand how it will affect. If you are not making any payment, if you didn't make any payment, then it will show outstanding in outstanding report. By looking that report, you will come to know how much amount is pending. How much amount is pending, that amount we have to pay our supplier. Right now I am doing which voucher? Payment voucher. For purchase we have to make payment voucher. For sales we have to make receipt voucher. So purchase I will make payment voucher. Now for supplier A, you can make half payment or full payment. How you are paying, that much amount you can enter here. I will enter here full amount 1,49,700. One single payment I will clear outstanding. Here, see here. Now you are getting three vouchers. Three vouchers we are getting now. Before when I enter here, I was getting only one voucher. Already three vouchers were there in this company. But still I was not getting that two vouchers here, because in that previous purchase voucher I didn't use this bill wise option before. Because in previous you can see, without using bill wise details option, I did so many entries in tally. So when I use this feature now today, that previous voucher is same like before, it didn't get updated. So I just updated that voucher by selecting that new reference, just refresh that entry. So right now I'm getting that voucher also. So three vouchers payment I have to make here. I will select one by one every voucher, enter. Again I will give against reference. Again I will give against reference. I will clear all the payment enter, 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 just accept this entry. That's it, simple. For purchase ID, payment. So we have settled that payment. So how it will affect in report? Let's see. Display, statement of accounts, outstanding, you can go payable or ledger or group, whichever you want. I'll go to payable. See here, there is no payment pending. Every payment is cleared here. There is no pending amount to pay. So when you open bill payable, your company no need to pay any amount to supplier, which is already cleared everything, supplier. So this is the bill payable report. I think you have understood how to select new reference in purchase voucher and how you can select against reference for that purchase voucher opposite against entry, which is payment voucher, and clear that bill. How it will affect in your outstanding report, where you can see outstanding report, how you can use this method of adjustment, new reference and against reference. This much enough for today tally session. I will end this session today and I will continue this same feature session in my next video also. Thanks for watching my video.